Today on an all-new Anderson Live.
Before you make that reservation,
this will freak you out.
How dirty are the restaurants and hotels you visit?
To find gonorrhea in an area where kids are playing, were you shocked?
A special Anderson Live hidden camera investigation. Learn the top three germ hotspots.
Today on an all-new Anderson Live.
10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6.
Stand by,
five,
Anderson.
Four.
Ready, camera five.
Three,
and
two,
make
one.
Your move.
Coming up next.
Then you look over here. Look at this wonderful microwave. Oh, that looks sanitary, doesn't it?
I also want to introduce you to Howard Cannon. Howard is a restaurant consultant. He's the guy you bring in when you find a finger in your chili. He's brought in by insurance companies and others to kind of investigate and figure out what's going on. Howard, appreciate you being with us over here.
Thank you.
So, hey. So what are the areas for you're going to show us some areas for caution in terms of food items?
Yes, sir. The reality is there's about 76 million cases of foodborne illness a year in this country, 3,000 deaths. And things that people rely on the most, something as simple as iceberg lettuce, they'll let it sit at room temperature because they're expecting to be busy, and you get your dressing. The dressing is, in many instances, been sitting at room temperature as well. Bacteria is growing on all of it. And if you take this lettuce and pull it apart like that, and if you could take the dressing and pour that on there, this plate here is for your spoon afterwards. So you put it on there. And really what you've done is moved the bacteria from that dressing that's been sitting at room temperature to that salad wedge that's been sitting at room temperature.
Right.
Someone leaves. A few hours later, they're sick. They go to the hospital. And it's all because you didn't handle the lettuce right.
Okay, now the lemons, like whenever I'm on a plane and I order like a diet soda, they say, do you want a lemon or lime? I used to always say, yeah, sure, why not? Now, I don't.
Exactly. Well, there's two issues with it. Number one, the outside of the lemon does not tend to get washed the way it should. But also, they cut these wedges well in advance. And then they sit them on a plate so that they can prepare for high volume.
Right.
Well, so what happens? They take the lemon, they put it in the water. If you want to give that a go.
Sure, I'd love to.
Usually they squeeze it first.
Oh, sorry.
Or they put it on the edge of the glass.
My hands are covered with gonorrhea.
Again, she moved the bacteria from the lemon to the water.
Right.
Somebody gets sick.
And now it's all swirling around. Okay, what about what's this?
The third item here is condiments. We've all seen condiments sitting at our local restaurants. What people don't tend to think about is this is sitting at room temperature all day, sometimes in the hot beating sun, and a fly flies around, and it lands on top of the condiment. What do you think it's doing on top of that condiment?
Spreading.
It's a little dirty fly business?
In many instances, it's laying eggs.
Oh!
Oh, really?
And the eggs then drop into the condiment.
Oh.
This is worse than I thought.
Which gives the little baby something to eat.
I get self-conscious even with the salt thing, because I figure how many people, like, you know, with dirty hands and little kids with snot in their nose have been playing with the salt thing, and I doubt they clean it.
Well, they clean it. They'll take a wet towel and they'll rub the top of it, which actually makes the flies attracted to it even more.
Oh, because it brings residue from other things onto that.
Yes, sir. Food.
What's your recommendations?
Well, needless to say, we've all seen these little packets. These little packets are much safer. Everything is contained in them. The other option is, you've seen a lot of restaurants now where they'll bring personally packaged
So you'd always go for individually packaged condiments?
Oh, absolutely.
And don't go for the lemons or the limes in your drink?
I would not go for the lemon or lime in my drink.
It is possible to take this stuff too serious. I mean, there's bacteria all around, and you know, we get adapted to a certain amount of bacteria, right?
Yes, but 3,000 people a year die in this country from foodborne illness. That's a huge number.
Right.
So you got to worry about personal responsibility.
Yeah, that's for sure. Listen, now you freaked me out.
I didn't mean to do that.
No, but it's good. I think these are simple things, the individually wrapped condiments, the not having the lemons and the limes in the drinks.
Exactly.
The lemons and the limes and the drinks. Howard Cannon, thank you so much. Appreciate it. So coming up next, very excited, Julie Andrews is here. We'll be right back.